Cuphead, a run-and-gun shump big boss battle bullet hell hybrid, was developed and published by Studio MDHR. Released on September 29, 2017, it's currently a Microsoft Windows and Xbox One console exclusive. Believe it or not, the developers tried everything from a Japanese demon in a top hat to characters with a plate or a fork for a head, and over 100 other designs, before settling on the main protagonists we know today. In fact, the final design for Cuphead was influenced by a 1936 Japanese propaganda animated film where a man with a teacup for a head morphs into a tank. It was revealed during an Xbox press event at E3 2014, but Cuphead's development actually began way back in 2010. In fact, brothers Chad and Jared Moldenhauer originally attempted a Cuphead-style game in the year 2000, but lacked the tools to continue. Inspired by 1930s cartoons they'd watched as children on VHS compilations, they found that the style of animation was strange, but in a good way, and it stuck with them. Chad, who had previously worked in graphics design, would be tasked with hand-drawing the animations and painting the background, while Jared would work on other aspects of the game. The game's playstyle they would work on together, and as time progressed, three further members were added to the project. The studio hired an animator, a jazz musician, and a developer to share the workload, because they sought to keep the animation and recording processes as true to the era as they could. It was decided that the game was to have a difficult retro run-and-gun feel, with emphasis on gameplay over plot. As development continued, multiple revisions were made, and the game's release date was even put back. Instead of the stereotypical rescue-the-maiden adventure most retro platformers are known for, they decided Cuphead would make trouble for himself. Multiple difficulty levels were included, and the number of boss battles increased, with the developers planning to obtain the Guinness World Record for the most boss battles in a run-and-gun game. At E3's 2014 press conference, it was believed Cuphead's game art was roughly 40% complete, but it was not available to play. Even though it won IGN's Best Xbox One Game at E3 Award in 2015 and was scheduled for 2016 release, the game was ultimately delayed significantly. Studio MDHR felt it did not want to sacrifice or compromise their ideas just so it could reach that earlier deadline, and decided instead for a September 29th, 2017 release. Possibly overshadowed a small bit by the SNES Mini coming out the same day, Cuphead released a very positive reviews. A game that can be as hard as balls in parts, it constantly teaches and encourages you to become a better player through the ongoing repetition of dying and learning boss or character patterns and the movements as you die some more. It requires skill, observation, cat-like reflexes, and at some instances, just sheer luck to progress. In the game, Cuphead and his brother are in debt to the devil because Mughead is pretty much a degenerate gambler. Having had a fabulous night at the Devil's Casino, he's offered one final throw of the dice. If he wins, all the casino's money is his, but if he loses, the devil gets his and Mughead's souls. What could go wrong? And so, after the inevitable conclusion of Mughead losing the bet and now being indebted to the devil, a deal is struck. Cuphead must traverse the game's three difficult world maps, finding, battling and defeating the devil's several runaway soul letters before he can be pardoned. You do get the odd bit of advice, occasional free gift, and the opportunity to do a bit of shopping as you progress, but there is a team that remains throughout the game. You will die a lot. It's not without its rewards though. Amongst the near controller smashing frustrations, there's also joy. That feeling of sheer bliss when you finally complete a level, the glee, the frantic and quite honestly cutest yet weirdest graphics you'll ever see in a video game can give you, it all helps and keeps you coming back for more. So despite being handed my ass on several occasions by villainous vegetables, a wicked witch, bothersome blueberry and more, these are just some of the bosses in the first world, by the way, I never once felt the overwhelming urge to rage quit and walk away. A cute as hell game will do that to you. There are power-ups in a classic sense that you're awarded and can buy as you progress, and these become more and more necessary as the difficulty rises throughout the game. What the game does do, it does well. Just as you think you're getting the hang of the mayhem, a new level of chaos is thrown at you. But if you just die endlessly like I did, you'll realise that you'll then learn the boss's patterns eventually and work out your own combination of strategy and power-ups so you can just push on through. One thing that should be mastered from the get-go is your parry manoeuvre. By parrying items with a pink lore hue, you'll earn cards that fill up your special gauge along the way. When full, you can use the current special move available or sometimes might even get temporary invincibility, a feat in itself that, for me at least, has often been the difference between level completion and witnessing the ever familiar death screen. As with most platforming style games, there are hidden features that can be only completed by sheer brilliance and repetition. Complete all the platforming levels without firing a single shot, and you will unlock another visual feature, giving everything an even more retro appeal. And even another series of steps for two-tone black and white look. But one step at a time, we need to learn how to not die all the time first. Cuphead's visuals are nothing short of amazing, and really do look like they're just out of a 1930s cartoon. Team that with a brilliant but frantic audio that fits in perfectly with the equally frenzied and furious gameplay, and you're left with a beautiful, brutal game. In short, Cuphead is amazeballs, and because of this, we'll keep bringing you back to willingly die some more.